Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are doing the September Shop My Stash. I tend to like to do these like right as September starts or a little bit before that, so I'm like ready to go once the month begins, but yeah, no, not this month. We started work back up at the end of August. If you know or if you don't know, I am a teacher, and the beginning of the year and the end of the school year are like the craziest times of the year for any teacher. Not only that, I'm actually switching grades. So just getting into that groove has been its own thing. So, been really, really preoccupied with work stuff. Other than that, it was kind of just casual vibe in August, even with work starting. Hopefully in September, I will be more into wearing, you know, my lipsticks and things like that. But again, with wearing masks, like we're back into that again. I don't really know, but we're gonna go with it anyway. What I like to do first is talk about the products that I used last month, see how many times I got use out of things, if I still like certain things. Okay, cool. Let's just get right into the recap. So for highlighters, I went into this Too Faced palette last month. It is the Super Fun Night palette, which is part of a limited edition, like trio of palettes that they don't make anymore. I wanted to use this Dashing Through the Snow highlighter, which it's not like my favorite highlighter in my collection, but it is still part of my collection, so I did want to use it because of that. I used the highlighter 4 times in August, and I quite like it. It is very subtle. It is not one of those like blinding, you know, super luminous highlighters, but it does give a little bit of a shimmer and glow. So it kind of worked for the kind of looks that I was making in August. So I will keep it in another month because highlighters and bronzers I usually keep in for 2 months. The other product that I used as a highlighter was the Too Faced Snow Bunny Bronzer. I use this product right here as a highlighter because on me, this bronzer turns up as a highlight. Really cannot see it on my hand, but on my face, it is a very subtle highlighter. And I was actually questioning if I wanted to get rid of this highlighter or bronzer, whatever it is, because of that reason. I wasn't sure if it was turning up on me, if it was worth keeping, but I actually really liked using that product a lot. I actually used that 6 times, and it's kind of one that I like to reach for over this guy, and I actually want to keep it, so that's cool. And I'm glad I know I like that product, because I was thinking of decluttering it, but if I still like it, what's the point of decluttering it, right? Might as well just use it. I actually use the bronzer here as well. This is the Too Faced Chocolate Soleil bronzer. I really, really like that one. I used that 5 times last month. I really like both of those. Those will continue to stay in for another month. The Betty Luminizer bronzer I also used in August, and this guy I used 7 times. So I definitely went for this more than the Chocolate Soleil one, but this is a very warm toned, you know, very shimmery pigmented bronzer. So it definitely turns up on your skin. I like using this. It's been a favorite bronzer of mine. You have to be very aware that it is very pigmented because it can look very strong. Now, I used to use this as a contour shade, like right here, and I'm rethinking that because it is a little too orange for that, and so I just have to be really careful with that. Put that one down. That's staying in for another month. I'm going to be switching out the Peach Perfect Too Faced Mattifying Loose Setting Powder. I've had this in for probably like 3 months or something, and I'm kind of done using it for now. It's very peachy, very Quaker Oats peach scented oatmeal flavor, like, and I just need a break from it. Yeah, the scent of this gets very strong, and I don't really like love it as a setting powder. Doesn't really do much for me. Like, it does mattify the skin, but I want to use other powders right now and kind of compare this one to it because I've just had it in for so long. So I'm gonna roll this guy out. I brought in 4 lip products. The more colorful of the bunch, which is the Sexy Mother Pucker lipstick. This is by Soap and Glory, weirdly enough. This is called Pommy Girl, a bright magenta color, and very pretty. I wore this about 3 times this past month, which for me is pretty good because I don't tend to wear very colorful lipsticks most of the time. So the fact that I was able to wear this 3 times, I'm proud of that. So I do really like this lip color. It's a pretty good formula, a little bit more on the mattifying side. It's a nice lipstick. The Bite Beauty, this is the shade Cashew. This is the old packaging, old formula. I got this on clearance, brownie nude color. I wore this guy 4 times. It was the kind of dark lipstick I felt comfortable wearing sometimes. I really like this lipstick. It is getting a little bit older. It's discontinued now. Bite lipsticks, I don't think they have a lot of preservatives in them. I'm not sure how that works. I mean, it still smells pretty good, but I don't want to sleep on this too much because of the type of formula it is, sort of a thing. I'm happy I used this 4 times. This is Maybelline Baddest Beige. It is one of my staple nude lip colors. It's a pale nude on my lips, but very easy for me to use with any eye look pretty much. So I love this guy. I used Baddest Beige 4 times last month. Random number generator actually pulled this lipstick for me, but it is a favorite and I was happy to get 4 more uses out of it. Other product that I pulled in last month was the Tarte lip paint in the shade Birthday Suit. This is discontinued, sadly. I really, really like this shade. This is a sample, of course. They gave it away in one of those like Sephora birthday gifts 1 year and I always liked it. Wish I bought the full size, but didn't know they were gonna discontinue it. The pinky nude color, and it is a little bit drying on its own, but I kind of mixed it with a lip gloss and it looked really, really nice. And I pulled the stopper out of it so I could get every last bit out. There's still a bunch in here left and that's great because I love this. I only got to use this 3 times in August. I think I'm ready to roll it out because I have so many nudes that I want to use, including Project Pan stuff. So for now I'm gonna roll it out, but I do want to start, you know, maybe finishing it up at some point just to kind of move it out, especially since it's discontinued. And I know, like, sometimes it's funny with discontinued products, like you want to hold on to them for as long as possible because there isn't any more of it left anymore to buy. But I also feel like I need to move on to things. Like if I need this product again, this kind of color, I want to be able to move on and find this shade in a brand that has a more permanent line. So I pulled in 2 Tarte blushes last month, Thankful, and this is the shade Party, and they're very, very different, as you can tell. I like the Tarte blushes a lot. Party I used 7 times, and this guy right here, Thankful, I used 8 times. This one is discontinued, by the way. This was a limited edition many years ago. I felt a little more drawn to the brighter color, which is weird because being somebody who is more neutral and like kind of low-key with makeup some days, most days, depending on the vibe of what's going on, you would think I would reach for this one more, but I think because this is like, I don't know, it's weird how that happens. I just feel more drawn to this guy than this guy. Had to make myself kind of go for the more nude one, which is so weird to me, but things to note. I'm gonna talk about this Lorac powder too. I didn't like pull this in last month. I've kind of had this on my dresser for a couple of months now. This is the Porefection Bake Perfecting Powder in Medium. And this was one of my favorite powders. Really liked the finish of this. It does kind of blur out your pores. I don't always want to reach for this. I think because I kind of want something that's really gonna set my makeup. And while this does blur out my face, or sorry, while it does blur out my pores, it doesn't necessarily do a great job, I don't think, at like setting my makeup overall, and that's kind of what I look for in a setting powder. So I guess like for its purpose, it's awesome. I like the finish of it. I think I need to kind of roll this guy out for now because I don't really want to reach for it too much right now, and it's not really what I need in my routine at the moment. So I'm gonna roll this powder out, even though it is a really nice powder. Let's talk eyeliner. The eyeliner that I use the least, that is the MAC Waveline eyeliner, a navy / violet eyeliner that is really, really pretty. I only wore this one twice though. I still do like it. It just wasn't one that I was like naturally like, ooh, I want to wear that today, you know what I mean? But at least I got 2 more uses out of it. It is a very nice stay put liner because it's blue, right? I feel like it has to kind of be very, it has to kind of go with everything else I have on my face. Kind of had to think about it a little bit more than the other stuff, so that's why I only got 2 uses out of this. I got this cake liner from Etsy. It says Georgiana on here. I don't think that's the actual brand of it. I think it's just like a cute like little sticker that they put on there that's like a vintage vibe. I decided to use this as an eyeliner, which is another alternative for a product like this. And Iris, if you're watching, thank you for that suggestion to give it another shot. So as an eyeliner, I liked it. I thought it was gonna go on a lot blacker though. Like, I thought it was going to be more of like a striking black, but it turned out to be more of like a gray, slate gray type of color. But that's okay because I actually like that kind of more subtle eyeliner look a lot of days. So, and I wore this as a liner 4 times last month, which isn't too bad. I'm still kind of playing around with this as a product and how I like to use it, if I like to use it, that kind of a thing. But as an eyeliner, it's not too bad. Sure, I could probably build it up to be inky black, but that's not how it goes on initially. Avon Dark Brown Eyeliner, one of my favorites. Really, really love this guy. I used this 5 times last month, so this is one of my favorites. Like I said, I say that every time I talk about this product. I really, really love it. It's getting shorter and shorter and shorter, but I just enjoy it so much. And it's just a staple eyeliner in my collection. So glad to get 4 uses out of this. L'Oreal Dark Slate Eyeliner. I don't really get like super excited to use this eyeliner. It's just there for like a little bit of definition, but it's not like a standout product in my mind. It's just kind of there, and I kind of sometimes just don't feel like using it, to be honest with you. I used this 4 times though, so while it's not the most exciting eyeliner, it does the job. It gives definition and it stays put pretty well, I guess, but it's not one that I'm like really excited to reach for because it's a gray eyeliner. In addition to the Project Pan eyeshadows that I use every single month, I did pull in a couple more, so I'm gonna talk about the 2 that I use the least, the colorful eyeshadows. So I pulled in the Urban Decay AC/DC eyeshadow, and this guy I actually really, really like. I was kind of not sure how I felt about it, so I'm happy I did pull it in. It is not one I typically think to use in August, right? But it is really, really pretty. Whenever I look at this in the pan, I always think it's gonna go on like really dark, so I never like wanna reach for it. But no, it is like way more subtle than you think and looks really, really pretty in the crease. Yeah, this is a keeper for sure. So sometimes the numbers of usage doesn't always mean you hate something. It just means it didn't quite fit with more of an everyday look. The NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in the shade Lime. Now, this one I also only used 2 times. Potential Chopping Block Eyeshadow. Worn this in the past and really liked how it looked. I think that's why I'm a little bit confused about if I like this one or not, but I feel like the last time I wore this, which was like last month, I was kind of like, it's okay. There's like a lot of this left. It's just like a lot of something that I don't wear enough. Much as I like this kind of green, I don't know if this is the kind of delivery system I really want with it. I don't know if this is the amount of product I want for this. It just seems like a lot for something that I don't know if I really, really love it. The Bare Minerals color, I'm not gonna like open the lid because it can get really messy, but this is the shade Sex Kitten, and I wanted to play around with this one because I wasn't sure how I felt about it. It's a kind of a brown that I always forget how it looks. Long story short, I really liked this color on my lid. I thought it was really, really pretty in the crease or just on the lid on its own. Very, very pretty shade. So this is a keeper. Same with this e.l.f. Toasted shade. This is discontinued. You can use like wet, dry. And I feel like I have very similar shades to this, but this has really, really nice pigmentation. A lot of it broke off. It was already fragile because I had broken it earlier, and then I tried to, you know, use the alcohol and mold it back together, but it's fractured, and once it's fractured, it's just gonna keep breaking. So I decided to like throw out the part that was just breaking. It's just so much product. We all know that eyeshadow takes years to get through, so why am I trying to like y'all hoarding the little broken pieces? It's beautiful, still like that one. Sex Kitten I wore 4 times, which is pretty good for me for, you know, all the shadows I used during the month. So 4 times I used Sex Kitten. The Toasted shade I only used 3 times, which isn't too bad either. As long as I hit my shadows around 3 or 4 times, like to me, that's pretty successful. Nude Beach right here by Bare Minerals is a shimmery, now I will unscrew this guy, but this is a shimmery kind of powder that kind of goes on. Someone's using their weed whacker. I don't know how much you guys can hear the weed whacker, but it's kind of annoying me. Nude Beach is really, really pretty. And I really like this shade for just like bringing a little bit of light to my eyelid. Like if I wore a darker eyeshadow and I felt like it was a little too dark, maybe I mixed that in a little bit on the lid and it was really, really pretty and nice. So I still like this one a lot. I used this guy 5 times, which I didn't realize that I used it that much, but apparently I did. Another Bare Minerals one. I'm really trying to rotate all of these because I have so many of them. This one is called Bare Skin, and this one is on the pinker side, pinker than you might think. It is pretty. This is one of those shades that I don't know how I feel about it. Like, I don't hate it. I like it. It looks pretty enough, but it doesn't like pull me in. I'm trying to downsize my collection if I can, and if there are shadows that I aren't really that excited to use, I'm trying to really reconsider keeping certain things like that. Not that I'm saying you have to like jump for joy for every single eyeshadow. I do think like shadows like this do have a place. The question is, how many of them do I want to keep around? You know what I mean? Especially if I'm not like that excited about it. So this is another one that I'm kind of like, I like it, but I'm not 100% sold if I love it type of a shadow. So I'm going to put that aside as well, hopefully remembering that, and might add it to my chopping block. And that bare skin one I just used 4 times. The last two are by MAC. I pulled in Naked Lunch, and this guy I actually used 5 times. And this was actually the star of all the eyeshadows that I brought in. And I was really surprised because I wasn't sure if this was going to turn up. Like, I didn't remember how it looked on me. And I was kind of like, oh, I don't know. Like, it looks kind of boring and whatever. So this does have a pinkier kind of base. These are not swatching for Jack right now, but it does have a pinkier base, even though it is like a more neutral kind of shade. But this really was super handy to wear a lot of the time. This was an easy to throw on the lid type of shade that I never had to think about. It still kind of showed that you were wearing eyeshadow, but it wasn't like in your face. Yeah, it went with a lot of other eyeshadows if I wanted to wear another eyeshadow in the crease, whatever. Like, it was just a really good workhorse eyeshadow. It can be one of those eyeshadows that gets lost in my MAC collection there, because I have a lot of like neutrally MAC shades and I forget how a lot of them look. I always feel like they kind of look alike, but this was really, really nice, and I'm really happy that I got a chance to pull it in and play with it and use it 5 more times. Okay, did we hit everything from August? I think we did. I think we're ready to move on and pick out some products for September. Let's go for it. Hey guys, so I usually pick my eyeshadows first. I already looked at my list to see, you know, what I haven't used yet in a while. So I kind of am basing my decisions on that, as well as, you know, how I like to wear my makeup right now. So one I haven't worn in a while is this e.l.f. Bark eyeshadow. I will show you guys more about this when I have 2 free hands. Grace right here. This is a Bare Mineral shade. Yeah, for my palettes, I think I'm gonna go with the Wet n Wild old version of the Comfort Zone palette, because I haven't used this in a while. Talk more about that too. This Smashbox trio, which is called Sepia. And I think I want to go with one more color. I'm gonna actually pull in this pink color because I don't have any bright colors now. So I wanted to have 2 hands free so I could actually like show you a little bit more detail, but this is the old version of the Wet n Wild Comfort Zone. And I was kind of, you know, dragging my heels on pulling this one in because I feel like I've used a green like this so many times, like recently. I've also used like this kind of golden shimmery type of palette color scheme multiple times, but I also feel like I haven't used this palette in ages. And I mainly keep this because of this shade right here, a reddish teal duochrome. So it's like really unique. Even though I've seen this duochrome done multiple times in different brands, I still really, really like that color. So that is really the main reason why I've been keeping this palette for so long. But otherwise, I feel like it's getting old. It's just showing its age, and the formula is still really good. It's still like buttery and like pigmented and everything. I just feel like I have a lot of these colors like multiple times in my collection. This color is just okay. This is really, really dark. I don't need a, it's almost like black. Yeah, so even though I'm not really sure about this palette and if I want to keep it around, I am excited to get more use out of this one. This is the color Delight, more of a lilac pink than an actual pink. So this is a really nice one. It is a lot more wearable than I assume it will be because it is so bold. So I remember that from a project where I had this shadow in. So I'm excited to get more use out of this guy. The Smashbox Sepia trio I haven't used in so long, and I was a little bit hesitant to pull this one in because this shade right here, which is like the medium shade in this little trio, looks a lot like Buon Fresco in my Modern Renaissance palette, which I am trying to hit 30 uses on or hit pan. And it looks, yeah, I don't like to have too many like repeat colors in my monthly rotation, but at the same time, it's been so long since I've used this, it could look completely different than what I'm thinking. It looks like dark purple, but it actually is kind of brownish. I don't know, but I think this could be interesting to play with, even though I've been dragging my feet on this one too. I think it's just a good idea to just pull things in, even if we're hesitant, and that way we can actually see what's going on. So That's that. And this is the Bare Minerals Grace eyeshadow. Sort of like Nude Beach by Bare Minerals, but this is a little bit more translucent and shimmery than Nude Beach. So there isn't as much pigment in this as there is like more shimmer in it. And the shimmer, and you can't really see it here, it has a very, very slight iridescence. So this is an interesting color. It is very interesting. And this was one of those shades that I was contemplating decluttering because I wasn't sure like if I really want a shimmery, iridescent, not so pigmented type of eyeshadow. You know what I mean? So yep, I'm here to figure that guy out. And same with this one, the Elf Bark eyeshadow that is no longer made. I feel like it's always going to be a lot darker, but then when I swatch it, it's not. I'm just curious how I like wearing this. I don't know if you have to wet this for it to show up better or... yeah, I need to figure this guy out because I haven't used it in a while and I'm just not sure how it turns up on me. So I want to play with that. I think this will round out my eyeshadows for September. I think with the Project Pan eyeshadows, I think this is a good enough amount to pull in. This palette has quite a few shades in there that I can kind of play with if I need to. So that'll be my eyeshadows. So I already said I'm not pulling in any highlighter or bronzer this month. I did want to switch out my powder, my Peach Perfect one, for the Tatcha powder down here. So this one I got free from influencers. I don't really get a lot of stuff from influencer these days, but I was fortunate enough to get a Tatcha one, which is really cool. And I just wanted something different to use than the peach scented powder that I was using forever. So I'm gonna pull this one in. It's nice from what I remember, but it didn't like wow me, right? So whatever, it's a setting powder. I feel like a lot of them are very similar, so I just want to switch it up. For lip gloss, I don't want to pull in a ton because I have quite a few in my Project Pans right now. I'm going to pull in for this month this NYX Butter Gloss in the shade Praline. This shade looks pretty brown, but I feel like this could be a nice neutral in a way too. Like in my head, it feels like it's really brown, but I could probably swing this even with a mask. I know, like I'm not crazy about wearing gloss under a mask, but as long as I don't pile it on, it'll be okay. I tend not to reach for like, you know, darker type of lip gloss. I don't want it just sitting around collecting dust, and I feel like this is a good month to wear a color like this. This is the only lip gloss I'm gonna pull in. It is a little bit seasonal in my eyes. It's not something I'm pulling out in the spring or summer really, so we'll see how it goes. I am a little bit hesitant on bringing in a ton of lip products because of the Project Pan lip products that I have. I want to get a lot of use on those products, but at the same time, I don't want to sleep on these products. So let's see. I think I'm only going to pull out like one nude lipstick. This is my nude tray right here. So I don't want to, again, overwhelm myself because a lot of my lip products right now that are out on my dresser are nude colors. Oh God, I'm having a hard time deciding. This really old NYX round lipstick. This is in the shade Perfect. And there isn't a whole lot left of this, and this would be a really good candidate for like a Project Pan if I didn't have like a few lip products in my Project Pan already. So I don't know, I'm thinking about keeping this guy in for more than a month just to get as much use as I can out of it. Pretty sure it's discontinued. It has to be. I don't think I've seen this online. This is different enough to not compete with all the other nudes that I have because it has that pinky or mauve undertone, but it's still like really cool for fall. So I'm going to pull this one in and get a lot of use out of that. And that's all I'm pulling in for my, you know, nude type of colors because I just have too many of those right now going in my collection. And I've used most of these like pretty recently anyway. So I feel okay with that decision. For pinks though, these are really bright, not really the fall vibe. And this one I feel like I used recently. Actually, you know, this one, I might pull in this one. This is, yeah, this is pink, but it's not a bright, bright pink. So I could see myself wearing this more than the other stuff. And you know what? Even if I get to wear it one time, then I wear it one time. Like, that's okay. So I'm gonna pull in this Ulta Crayon in the shade Soiree. I'm not quite ready to pull in purples for this month, maybe October. But I feel like there's a red that I could probably swing this month. Okay, I'm gonna pull in Frickin' Frack by ColourPop. This is something that looks really nice for September. And Yeah, so I think for lipsticks, I'm only gonna pull these three in just because I do have a lot of like Project Pan stuff. I don't wanna overwhelm myself. So if I get to two or three times, that's awesome. But yeah, I don't wanna neglect these things either. So we're gonna pull these in. All right, now I'm gonna pick out some blushes. I usually roll in about two. I have one Project Pan blush. So I don't think I'm pulling out any here. And no, I don't feel drawn to use any of these right now. What haven't I used or what am I on the fence about? I think I'm gonna pull in this NYX blush. This is the shade Dusty Rose. I have mentioned in previous videos that my NYX blushes are getting up there in age and I don't know how I feel about them in terms of keeping them around. I'm not sure about the staying power. They're very old. I wanna give them another try and see if they're worth keeping. This one is the more pigmented of the three, or yeah, you can see it's like very pink and pigmented. And I think that sometimes that looks really nice and I like that more pigmented look with my blush. It depends. So yeah, I kind of want to play with this more before I make any decisions. So I'm going to pull this one in. I'm actually going to pull in this one right here. This is one of my newer blushes that I purchased. This is the Glossier Cloud Paint in Storm, which I did have this in like just sitting on my dresser because it was new. I wanted to like play with it, but this is that shade that is a little bit darker. I didn't want to reach for this a whole lot in like the spring and summer, which is when I got this, but I think now is the time to really get some use out of this. So it is newer, like I said, but it is a cream product. Like, I don't want to have it sitting around for too long before getting to use it. So I'm going to really take advantage of this month. Here is where I house my mascaras, brow products, and eyeliners. And I don't have a ton of mascaras. I only have like 3 to 4 of them. So I don't really feel like I need to be very conscious of using them, but I feel like I have not used my Dior Edol mascara in a while. It's a sample. I was really trying to pan my Marc Jacobs sample, so I've been ignoring this one a little bit. So yeah, I still want to pan the Marc Jacobs one, so I'm gonna keep working on that, but I want to get like a few uses out of this too, just so it's not sitting around. I want to kind of switch it up a little bit, so getting a little bored of using the Marc Jacobs one so much, and sometimes I pull this one out too to use, so I'm just gonna make sure I get any kind of use out of this month. It is a cool wand too. I'm not sure if this is like a tubing mascara. I think it kind of is. It is very defining. And I like a more voluminous type of mascara, but this one isn't bad. It's not bad. I mean, I wouldn't buy it, you know, full size, but I'm gonna get more use out of this guy. I forgot to mention this in the recap, but I have been using this NYX Cake Brow Powder for 2 months, I wanna say. Essentially these are eyeshadows, if we're being real here. And I really do like this though, as a brow filler. But I think I need to kind of get back to my cream products. So I really liked using this and, but yeah, I have 2 other brow products, which I'm sure you've seen this on my channel before. The Morphe one, micro brow pencil in the shade Java. So I kind of miss using this. And this guy, Anastasia Dip Brow Pomade in Chocolate. I have mixed feelings about this. I like using it, but I feel like it's so dry now. Like you can still get product on your brush, I feel like. I've had this forever. I don't know if you can get bored of a brow product, but that's kind of how I'm starting to feel with this. I have to see how well this goes on. I haven't used it in 2 months. I'm sure it probably performs just fine and I'm just like imagining things right now, but I'm gonna pull it back out. Back to using these two. I know I only have like 3 brow products, so it's like, what am I rotating? But I did use this for 2 months, so we're gonna put that one away and focus on these two for brows again. So for eyeliners, there's 2 that I know I want to focus on. So these are getting shorter and shorter, which is great because we need to use up eyeliners and kick them out eventually because these are so old, but I still like all of these. The only eyeliners I want to pull in this month are the 2 Eskido ones. The brand is Eskido. And I received these when I was a blogger, which was many moons ago. And I feel like these are that kind of formula that is soon to dry out. So these are gel eyeliner pencils. This one's just your typical black one. And as you can see, like, it doesn't really go on super evenly anymore, but you can still get it on there. So this is like, yeah, kind of reaching its probably declutter time.
So I'm sure it's like long expired, but if I can get it to go on, I'm, you know, going to try to see what I can do with it, if it works, if it's worth keeping. But I remember liking it, and I feel like it has really good staying power. So we're going to pull this one in, and this is the Esquito liner in brown. It's a pretty good one too. This one I feel is a little bit more consistent, like when you draw the line, than this one. It doesn't skip as much as this one does. So yeah, maybe I just need to warm that one up a little bit more, but I want to get use out of both of these. I feel like it's been a long time. And again, the formula is a ticking time bomb at this point, because Lord knows I have so many like black eyeliners I could use. I don't want to keep around anything that doesn't perform that great, but I do like the brown one. That one works pretty well. I know that. So these are my eyeliners and the Project Pan one. Those are the ones I'm going to be using this month. All right, so now it's time to transfer all of my picks for September into my setup here. So that's what we're gonna do. And just to give you a quick explanation, all this stuff is like Project Pan stuff, or stuff that I always have out, like a lip balm. This is a Project Pan item. Always have these out. These are the only foundations that I have. So those stay out all the time. They don't go away. So let's put everything else in. That I finally got to film my September Shop My Stash. Thank you for watching till the end, and as usual, please give this video a like. Definitely consider subscribing, and yeah, I will see you in the next video. Hopefully that one will be sooner than 2 to 3 weeks from now. We will see how September goes, but again, thank you, and I will catch you in the next one. Bye guys.